and listening skill. Now we are going to see speaking skills. Speaking means it is the ability to express opinions or thoughts. Means that a person will be able to express verbally his feelings, his thoughts, his inner ideas, all these kind of things. Okay, this could be this particular skill is also known as productive or expressive skills, and this skill is the ability to communicate effectively. Okay, the most major aspect of speaking is fluency. Now, speaking skills convey messages in a passionate, thoughtful and convincing manner. So, if you have good speaking skills, you will be able to convey the messages in a very meaningful manner. Okay. So, there are three types of speaking situations, that is interactive, partially interactive and non-interactive. So, in an interactive session, how that term denotes, you know, in this particular mode of speaking, people interact with each other, recurrent coding and decoding is happening around. Okay, now partially interactive means that sometimes the speaker switch on to the listener and then this happens. But non-interactive speaking is a kind of interaction in that situation. For example, like in radios or TV, they are interacting without any kind of interactions. There is nothing happening between two people. This one word mode of speaking is happening, and this is non-interactive speaking situation. Now we have the speaking skills. How can we say that someone has the skills? There are few skills that enables a person to speak well. Okay, those specific skills are to produce the characteristic English speech sounds and sound patterns both in isolation and combination, that is phonetics skills, including phonetics skills, that is the speech sounds, the patterns, the words, the person should be able to do that. And then use appropriate stress and intonation patterns, and then use appropriate words and structures to express the intended meaning, and of course to recall these words and structures. Now, the other skill is that to organize thoughts and ideas into logical sequence and then to adjust the speech according to the audience. These are some of the important speaking skills a person who can speak in English should have. And then we can see some other skills, that is sub skills. So these are sub skills, that is be prepared and practice, and it is very important that you know your audience. Try to keep everything short and simple and try to interact with your audience, not just conveying all the messages in a very emotionless or without any interaction. It's not good. As if you want to be a successful speaker and if you can say that you have a speaking skill, then that means that you should be able to interact with your audience, speak with sincerity and passion. Of course, the most important thing is that the fluency. Okay, now how can we develop speaking skills in our students? We can ask questions related to some interesting topics to our students, and then dialogue presentation, and make use of information gap activities using role plays, simulation, dramatization, communication games, guessing games, etc. Lots of games which helps the students or which make the students to communicate. And now by using substitution tables, discrimination exercises, substitution drills, conversation drills, then pictures, picture cues, interact questions, correction techniques, etc. And then of course pair works or group work techniques which enables them to communicate and speak so that their language, their skills as a speaker could be developed and improved. These are some of the aspects related to developing speaking skills. Now we can go to the next one.